Hey, yo, welcome, subscribers or watch time, which one is the most important? Today we're gonna find out which one is the most important, subscriber or watch time. Which one should you, as a small YouTuber, be focused on? Should you focus on watch time? Should you focus on getting that 1,000 subscribers? We're gonna find out today in this video. Stay tuned. Boom. Yo, what's good? It is your favorite YouTuber in the building, Chris Olingo, aka the GOAT. Welcome back to today's episode. Yo guys, on today's video, we're gonna find out which one is the most important. Is it watch time or subscribers? As a small YouTuber, which one you should be focusing on? Should you be focusing on getting more subscribers, or should you rather be focusing on releasing videos that are longer and trying to get the watch hours? Today, we're gonna find out which one is the most important. On the comment section, quickly let me know your favorite. Which one do you prefer, or which one do you think is the most important? Which one works best for you? On this video, I'm gonna explain to you, I'm gonna share with you guys my thought. Let's dive into the video. Guys, you all know that I host a YouTuber support every single Monday, but right now we on WhatsApp group. We've got a WhatsApp group that's going on. If you do not know anything about WhatsApp group, the WhatsApp group is right there. Guys, go down there and join the WhatsApp group, meet other small YouTubers and, you know, grow. So I get asked this question a lot from my subscribers, my friends, and the other viewers. Which one should I be rather focusing on? Should I be focusing on getting more subscribers, reaching that 1,000, or should I focus more on getting that 4,000 watch hours? So before we dive more into that question, I'm gonna tell you guys a requirement for YouTube in order for you to get monetized. Guys, for you to get monetized, you need at least a minimum of 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours within 1 year. Okay, within 365 days. All right, so which one is most important? Which one is it's hard to come by? My opinion. Which one is most important and which one is hard to come by? Some people, when they read this requirement of YouTube, they tend to think that the most important thing is actually getting subscribers, or that's a difficult thing, getting subscribers, according to them. Some say getting your watch hours is more important than actually getting more subscribers. So this is what I'm gonna advise people that are out here, that are making videos, or that wanna get monetized, or that have not yet reached the requirement, or some that are thinking of starting a YouTube channel. Guys, getting subscribers, it's a bit hard, but it's not the hardest, understand? But getting the watch time is hard and is the hardest, you know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying is this: you can easily get 1,000 subscribers with a video of 1 minute, 2 minutes, you know, all the time. You can get people that will watch your video. When you release a video, the amount of views it gets and the amount of watch time it gets on the first 2 hours, Google then push it out to more people, which gives you the potential of gaining more subscribers. All right, so gaining subscribers is very easy. No, gaining subscribers is the less difficult part, you understand? Where on the other end, watch time is just as important. Watch time is an amount of time that people spend watching your video, like you guys out there. You guys that are watching my video right now, I'm getting a watch time. So if you watch the video full, I get the full watch time, like the full length of the video. If this video perhaps is 15 minutes, 20 minutes, I get the full 20 minutes from one viewer that watches full. Now, if you perhaps watch the video and then in the middle of the video you click off, I only get like 5 minutes of that watch time. So bear in mind, you need to have 4,000 watch hours. If I can do the math, that is 240,000 minutes. All right. So when I post a video, you only watch like 5 minutes. So in that 5 minutes only counts, you know, it only counts 5 minutes. So I have a whole mountain to climb. Do you know what I mean? So watch hours is more important than getting subscribers. Because subscribers, you can easily get it with a video of 1 minute, 30 minutes, 30 seconds, 2 seconds, or as much as you can. People can just click on it and they like the first intro of your content, they really subscribe to you, you know. It's more about how many time people spend watching your stuff on the very first time that you drop it. The people enjoy it, they're gonna stay, or they're gonna subscribe. Even if the video is for 1 minute, they're still going to subscribe. So subscribers will come whether you like it or not. The subscription comes all the time. That is one way of you getting subscribers. You can easily post a video, small, large, doesn't really matter, but you're gonna get subscribers anyway. Okay, if you do not post a video, however, and you say, no, I'm not gonna post a video, there's still different ways of you getting more subscribers. You can go on your Instagram, you can DM people, you can speak to your family, you can speak to your friends, your WhatsApp people, people that you have on your WhatsApp, you can speak to them. People that you have on your Instagram, you can speak to them. Your friends, your followers on Instagram, you can speak to them. Your friends on WhatsApp, you can easily speak to them and ask them to subscribe to your channel. They can subscribe to your channel, but they have not watched your video yet. So you'll be growing in numbers, like you'll be growing more subscribers daily, more subscribe all the time, but then you are not getting the watch hours, you're not getting the watch time. So you are basically doing nothing, I should say. You're basically just barking at the wrong tree. Like, you can view it, you're getting subscribers, but you are not getting watch time. So this thing, watch time and subscribers, all go hand in hand. They go together. They're like best buddies, they're best friends. So for you to get monetized, you need to have 4,000 watch hours, 1,000 subscribers in the last 365 days. So this is a mistake that I see a lot of small YouTubers have. They tend to be driven by numbers, like the numbers, like the amount of subscribers they have on their YouTube channel. They fool themselves, like, okay, now I have this amount of subscribers, blah 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 blah, that means I'm doing well. You are doing well in getting subscribers, but then you will get to a point where you'll be stuck. Like, you reach 1,200, and then you will not have watch time. You will still not be monetized because you do not have watch time. Guys, watch time is a mountain to climb. That's the biggest, that's the most, you know, that's the heaviest thing to do. I've seen a lot of people that are, you know, have reached their 1,000 subscribers and even more. Some people have reached 1,400 subscribers and still not monetized because they have not, you know, they have not been focusing on those longer videos, you know, getting people, you know, stuck on their videos so that they can be watching those videos for a long time so that they get more watch time. People just focus on four minute videos and then bam, off they go. I know some of you guys think that people, if you drop us like a shorter video, people will enjoy it the most and then they'll, you know, watch it full. It's never the case. People watch your video where they like you. If they like you, they watch your video full. That's just what I'm saying. If they like you, they watch your video full. If they don't, then they don't watch it. I've seen a lot of people struggle. A lot of YouTubers, big YouTubers that are out there, not big, but people that I think, like, I've seen a lot of small YouTubers that have just started out. You see them, boom, bagging a lot of subscribers first time. You see them on the first 4 or 5 months, they already got like 1,800, but then subscribers. But then when they post a video, they only get about 40 views or 40 people that actually watch their video, and their videos are usually short. That's not a good idea. If you want to kill two birds with one stone, this is what you do. Of course, keep grinding for your subscribers and release longer videos. Pursue your people or show your friends or tell your friends or your family members to try to watch the video full so that you can get this watch hours. So the moment you are reaching your 1,000 subscribers, you're already reaching your watch hours. So if you're a small YouTuber right now and you're watching this, and all my friends that are watching this, please do not release shorter videos. Please try to release a video at least that more than 10 minutes, 15 minutes, at least 20 minutes. See, that's in that way you're gonna achieve your watch hours very, very quick. And then the moment you reach 1,000 subscribers, bam, you can apply for monetization. So that's my little advice, my little 2 cents, you know. Please, you're free to let me know in the comment section what you think. What do you think is most important? How is your strategy towards monetization? How are you approaching this monetization? How are you planning on getting monetized? Like, which method do you use? Which one do you think is the most important one? I think the most important one is watch time. If you can just search right now, you find out a lot of people that have got 1,000 or more, or two. I've seen or I know a person's got 2,000 subscribers and cannot monetize it because they've been focusing on 3 minutes, 4 minutes videos, you know. And then when they see viewers on it, they think they've made it big. And guys, one thing I want to say, guys, when you release a video as a small YouTuber, okay, and then you release a video right now, and your friend released a video like 4 hours ago, 2 hours ago, and then they have got like 200 or 400 views, and then you release a video now, and then you release a video like 2 hours ago, and then you have like 28 or 30 views. Guys, do not be discouraged by that. I mean, YouTube is not a sprint. It's not a race. It's a marathon. So the more you find out the people that are watching your video, actually enjoying your video, than the people that are cheese getting, that are watching, that are giving you more views, but are really clicking out of the video, which is in return, you find that people are watching your videos only for like a few seconds and then they click out, and you think you're having more views, that means you're having more watch time, which is clearly not the case all the time. People can only watch your video just to support you because you ask them on WhatsApp, hey, please watch my video, blah, 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 blah. Then you send them the link. They say, okay, I'm gonna watch this video for 2 seconds, 20 seconds. As long as he gets to see one view go up, he'll be all right. So they don't know, people that are watching your video do not know that you need this watch time. So they do not know. So they just wanna give you views. And you find that people that are always hustling and asking for, you know, sending links to people, people just watch the video and then they go out, they're happy because they got like 20 views in one day. I mean, 100 views in one time when they release the video. They think that's a good thing to do, which is not really the case, because people just watch your video for a few seconds and then click out. You will be so shocked if you go to an analytics and check out your videos, how they're doing, how many watch time you managed to get on your videos based on the views that you think you have and then how much watch time you think you actually made on this video. So longer video is the way to go, guys. Release longer video. Please pursue your friends when you're sending them the links. When you're sending them the link, please ask them to at least try it. If they want to support you, they should try to watch the video full and then support you, like, you know, subscribe to you. You shouldn't just send them the link and then ask them to watch the video and then leave a comment, like, blah, blah, blah. First thing they will watch the video for 1 minute or less and then leave a comment, like, and then they click out. So that really hurts you on your analytics and it hurts you on your, when you go to your algorithm, like, people are not really enjoying your video. That's what Google will think. Google will think people will click your video by mistake and then they watch for like 2 minutes and they don't like it and they kick out. But if you have friends, but if you speak to people and tell them, look, I'm trying to reach more watch time because that's Google. I know you guys think I'm on YouTube, I'm actually getting paid, but I'm not getting paid, but I might, you know, if I do this right. So I would want you to at least, you know, watch my video full so I can get this watch time going, because I need about 240,000 minutes. That's a lot of videos you gotta produce in order to reach those hours, reach those minutes, you know. But some people are like, when they release one video, all of a sudden the video goes viral, blah, 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 blah. That's usually the case, one out of 10 that do that, you know, your first video, bam, you go viral, and then people discover you, people subscribe to you, people watch this video full, and you get more watch time. But the reality of me and you in 2020 is that those miracles, those fairy tale stories do not really happen. So you gotta grind your own way, grind hard. When you're grinding, make sure you're speaking to people, telling them that you need them to watch the video, not just to click subscribe and then off they go. Subscribers do come, yes, and they're easy to come by because you can just meet anyone along the road and then wherever or at work, just ask them to subscribe to you and they will surely subscribe to you. But then, if you ask them to watch the video full, they're probably gonna say, nah, I don't have the time now, like, I'll watch it later. So yeah, so fight more for watch hours than you should. Fight more for watch hours, because it's most important, and they're all important, but watch hours is hard to come by. So if you can start tackling those watch hours right now, releasing videos of 20 minutes, 15 minutes upwards, and then asking people or exchanging playlists with people. Now that's another thing that I'm gonna tell people. If you wanna reach your 4,000 watch hours quicker, exchange playlists. You have WhatsApp group. I have got a group that I've created right now, so you can be on a group there. You can exchange playlists with people in the group. You know, there's about 100 people in the group you can exchange playlists with, and then, you know, make more watch hours. You know, that's what I'm trying to say. So if you are focusing more on subscribers, I would suggest that you should not really focus more on just getting numbers going up, but you should focus more on getting 4,000 watch hours rather than focusing on minutes and on subscribers, and then you reach 1,000, then you stop, like, I still need this. So then you say, you only realize then that you need to start, you know, pushing out videos that are longer than 10 minutes, you know, pushing out, you know, watch time. Subscribers do come, very easy to come by. You got friends, you got YouTube, you got Instagram, you got Twitter, which I don't really use. You got Twitter, you got WhatsApp group, you got Facebook group, you got, you know, there's a lot of ways to get subscribers, but there's not a lot of ways to get watch time. People are not gonna be out there watching your video. Like, they're not gonna enjoy, if they don't enjoy a video, they will not watch your video full. So that's just the way it is. So you need to focus on getting people that will wanna watch your video, that wanna support you, wanna watch your video full, so that you can get this full watch time, so that whenever you reach your first 100, whenever you reach your first 1,000 subscribers, you are already applying for monetization because you already, you know, done your watch hours, or you're close to finishing up your watch hours. Don't be out there, you reach 1,000, bam, and everyone is expecting you to start to get monetized, at least to get, you know, ads on your video, and then you're out there for at least another year, no ads, you know. Like, it's really frustrating. If you can tackle this right now, start making videos that are longer than 10 minutes, that could help a lot, you know. Like, it could help a lot. Like, because I've checked out my analytics. Videos that are released that are 5 minutes don't really give me much watch hours. They give me views, yes, but they don't give me much watch hours. But videos that are longer than 10, 15 minutes, I get more watch time from those videos, with people enjoying watching or trying to listen to things until it's end or whatever. If the topics that I'm covering, people enjoy it, they're gonna stick around for a long time. So whenever you're releasing videos again that are longer, please do not do videos that have to do with you, like personal videos. People don't really, you know, they're not gonna sit out there and watch your life for 20 minutes. But if you're out there doing, making videos that are longer than 20 minutes, yes, but then videos that are really covering topics that people are searching for, or people are searching for those type of answers in the topic. If you answer to the questions that people are searching for on the YouTube platform, people will most likely stick around for long. But if you are creating videos of yourself, you will get few that will wanna, you know, stay until whenever. So that is my answer to that question. YouTube subscribers and YouTube 4,000 watch hours. You need both of them to get monetized, but the most important one, the most difficult one, is watch hours. And you should know again that Google or YouTube is a platform where, it's a business platform, I should say. It's a business platform. I didn't mention it on my other video. It's a business platform. They want to keep people watch. They want to keep people on YouTube. They don't want people clicking out and going somewhere else. So they want to have everyone on YouTube. And YouTube is a business. So other companies come, they advertise the business on YouTube. So people that are there watching, the viewers that are watching there, they get to see that there's a company open, or this company promoting this and that, and then they get to click and buy from there. YouTube get the money, and then you get your little 5 cents. That is the goal of wanting people to stay on YouTube. So create longer, interesting videos that will keep people staying, or keep people watching, rather than just focusing on getting more subscribers, or, you know, because subscribers do come whenever you release a video. Something that they like, they subscribe. This is the way it is. Like, even this video that I'm releasing now, people might enjoy it, people will stay for longer. Some people might enjoy it, some of them will stay longer. Some of them will even subscribe because of the video that they receive. Because it's something that can be an answer to something they've been searching for. So release videos that are interesting. Release video, at least for now, that you're not monetized. Don't be out there doing videos that are so personal, because, I mean, no one's gonna sit around for 25 minutes, 30 minutes listening to your, or looking, or watching your whole life story, if they don't really know you. So make videos that are, you know, are evergreen. Give videos that are I'm gonna release a video similar to this, explaining what type of videos are actually evergreen videos and normal videos, like videos that don't really get you views. They only get you views once they're out and you get a lot of views, but once after 2 to 4 days, they don't really, you know, cover more views. But we're gonna talk about that next time. So guys, we reached the end of the video. If you are here for the first time and you don't subscribe to my channel yet, please subscribe to the channel and join the family. It is your favorite YouTuber in the building, Chris Olingo, and I'm signing out. Peace.